So I'm Bukuba. I'm a journalist. I'm
the
correspondent with the media newspaper here.
Yes.
I'm a freelance. And the case of Marafa, I think, is really a very sad. It's a sad incident to Cameroonians.
It's
a sad incident because from inception, even when he was caught, somebody like Marafa, who has been ex-secretary general of the presidency, ex-minister of territorial administration, and then today, he's being manipulated upon after being removed from Kondigli to set secretariat d'état de défense. But he was jailed there. He was put there under inhuman condition. I can't imagine somebody like Marafa kept there from 8 a.m. in the morning to 8 p.m. in the night under inhuman condition. A small cell, dark room. But fortunately enough,
how do you know that?
Yeah, how do I know that? From my last publication, the Median newspaper, which we happen to have carried out some investigation. That is the Median of Monday, 23rd of July, 2012, number 044. After investigation from the lawyer of Marafa, Professor Kofele Kale Ndiva, he made it clear that the conditions they are improving as of now, that it was not as it used to be.
So, now, explain to me how a country can treat a former senior servant, civil servant, to that extent.
Yeah,
like a mere street side bandit. How can that be?
Yes, it is what is happening. It's not like how can that be, because presently that is what we are watching. And it is like when you are stubborn, they put you in that condition, because in set there are few of them who are there. You have him, you have Polika Ababa and Yves Michel Fosso, and you know their crimes which they have committed. After the first crime, the case of Polika, who almost wanted to run away, wanted to escape. And Marafa, you know, he's just been stubborn, coming out with his letters. The case of Yves Michel, he has been almost thrown out from his family. So that is why they have been put there. So that's the most serious place where they put criminals in the country. Political criminals, as I may put it. But what about other persons who have stolen money in the coffers of the government? Where are they? Where is Katoriana Bena? The ex? That was the question I was asking today in a program which we carried on. We were doing in the Lakeside region. Where is Katoriana Bena, the former Secretary of State of Secondary Education? Where is she? She just cried that she was sick. She was taken to the hospital and she left. Where is Mendoza? Where are they? Look at the situation today. Some of them who have stolen money by the audit team, after having made their investigation, the Supreme Audit Team, they came out with some of the names, like the former government delegate of Limbe, Ebiama. We also heard the names of Munono Humphrey, the rector of Douala University, Bruno Bekolo, the rector of which other rector? The rector of Swa University, Jean Tabi Manga. Uh-huh. But they have been removed from their function. Why is it that Humphrey Munono is still there? At least if you realize that somebody has stolen money, then it is uncalled for you to allow that person to be working.
And then, when you begin this thing, your real point of emphasis was the
Marafa.
Inhuman condition given to Marafa.
Marafa, yes. It is really uncalled for a senior state personality like Marafa, incarcerated in a prison. But just like I said, that his main defense lawyer said that the condition is improving because it was not like as it was. Now at least he has a refrigerator. He has a small bed which he can lie down, though he does not have access to phone.
Yes,
and other communication
network.
So
you think the government is still afraid he may give the fifth letter?
Yes, that is it. But some people are already saying that the fifth letter has come out, but not clear, because the declaration which he made, he was supposed to make in court, but unfortunately the court session did not take place. Not took place on that day. But we are still waiting. Maybe he may come out with another his fifth episodes, which we don't know what he'll be alighting. But I think
heard about petrol. Like he may be talking about how petrol money was mismanaged in the country.
Yeah, we heard that too. Petrol, and what about the ill-gotten wealth of the head of state?
Because
a point to which we heard that he might be talking about.
So it means that Beato may also be in the dirty.
Yes,
place, right?
Yeah, maybe, because but it's unfortunate that it will be difficult, because now they have made it to press men that any press man who writes or talk about that, you will not face it very easy with the government.
And as a press man, are you going to just take government's diktat and stay quiet?
No, you don't stay quiet, because it is a very, very sensitive issue. It's a very, very sensitive issue, and the public wants to know much. about what is going on. So given that Mahafa comes out with a feed letter, which we don't know, they will know it's going to be very, very complex, because the mechanism that I've put around him, it is very, very complex for him to come out with that letter.
So you are you not optimistic about the letter?
I'm optimistic. My Issa Turuma himself, the Minister of Communication, said that Mahafa has about 500 of those letters. So he has released just four. So we are expecting more of those letters to come out.
But as a man from Southwest, I still ask myself this question. We have a former chief of Bakingili, former Prime Minister, former Assistant Secretary General of the Presidency, who also knows a lot. Why is he just so quiet, like I call it cocoa leaf?
It is not a matter of being cocoa leaf. He's not only the prime. He has never been. He's not only the ex prime minister. But remember, too, he's somebody who has followed. Has the people who are behind him.
Behind him?
Yeah, he's a chief. He's still a chief.
Then people are just so quiet now.
That's why I'm saying that, you know, he's a chief. And what has the chief done? What has the chief done? He's not a common man.
So why is it happening that Southwest is just that way now? Because I don't think if it's a Northwesterner, the Bamenda man will take it that way.
No, then too, it depends how the case. You know, justice is not easily given like that.
Yeah, but for a prime minister, my point is the prime minister, a chief.
Yeah, a prime minister, an ex-prime minister. A chief, an ex-prime minister. It's an ex-prime minister, and we should not expect that the public should move like that. We're expecting that the chiefs, they're the one to take their decision. If they don't say anything, then we should be waiting for
so
them.
So that he's not saying anything, does that really, are you for that type of attitude?
No, the public cannot just easily mobilize.
I mean, you, if he doesn't say anything for attitude, how do you see him? Is that a fair attitude to
It depends. He's a man who is coming from the slum. And most people who are coming from the slum, they are quiet. They have a respectable background. He said the father was a fisherman. Okay. So you can just imagine that he's coming from a slum.
Maintain what you can get on the way.
Yeah, the background is, that's it. So
a background that is doubtful.
Yeah, that is it.
Oh, so that's an instrument that I did not know now.
Yeah, so you know, those type of situations, sometimes you realize that most of them, they can see that I just picked you from the slum and make you what you are today.
So you just
forgetting that he must have studied somewhere.
That's the point. You're challenging your own intellectual foundation.
He's a well-trained person.
That's correct now.
Just like the case of Mahafa, Chiruma, who said Mahafa is Bia who made him to be so. But they are forgetting that they are trained.
That's right,
to be so. But they forget about that. Just say somebody must pick you, put you where you are supposed to be.
Thank you.
Be trained, but you don't have somebody who picks you.
Sir, if you are to, as a newsman always do, if you are to project from that, where is Cameroon going?
Where is Cameroon going to
with
be?
All this scandal from one to the other?
It's really difficult.
Prediction. Yeah, I know prediction.
The prediction, where is Cameroon going?
Yes.
Cameroon is going almost nowhere. We are still at a point where everything is just turning around. We are going nowhere because you look at everything, just like I mentioned earlier, those who have been incarcerated, it's just like a whole clique, because others who too have stolen money, they have been asked to pay back. The case of the Lefanda, the case of the Onfimuno, the case of the ex rector of Douala University.
So for you,
same
Cameroon
thing.
Is going nowhere.
It's going nowhere. We're still in standstill. The point is the same.
Home is camera.
Yes, we are still standpoint.
From my eye. Ladies and gentlemen, can you hear a prediction from a media man that his own country is